che tu presente a new alternative a possible therapeutic use of non-ionizing electromagnetic radiation at resonance frequencies of cellular membrane giant cells in breast cancer. This alternative method can be considered as an adjunct to the methods that we already know. In particular, the aim of this study is to provide a therapy for the treatment of cancer in general, in particular for breast cancer, that is more effective than traditional radiation therapy. Bystander effect. Non-ionizing radiation are electromagnetic radiations with a frequency that is below 3000 terahertz. At the frequencies upper than this value, we have X-rays, gamma rays, and the ionizing radiations, such as X-rays, protons, that are used in the conventional radiation therapy. Nevertheless, using radiation therapy, often there is the so-called bystander effect. Bystander effect is a biological effect that occurs after irradiation of cancer cells by X-ray or protons beams, and occurs in neighboring healthy cells that have not been directly irradiated. These effects can be DNA damage, mutation, or apoptosis. In particular, in literature, we know some harmful effects of conventional radiation therapy in breast cancer. For instance, the mortality for radiation induced usually occurs at least a decade after radiation. Coronary occlusion following thoracic radiotherapy appeared as and in the period of more than 10 years after the radiation, a woman had significantly higher survival than an irradiated control woman because of an excess of cardiac deaths. Finally, exposure of ERT to ionizing radiation during radiotherapy for breast cancer increases the subsequent rate of ischemic ERT disease. These harmful effects were observed after radiation therapy for breast cancer. What is the state of the art regarding the use of non-ionizing electromagnetic radiation for cancer treatment? Some clinical studies showed that the application of electromagnetic fields in cancer patients have inhibited the disease progression, prolonging the survival time or living sufferers of cancer. Nevertheless, the beneficial effects of exposure of tumor cells to electromagnetic fields were well below those produced by traditional treatments of cancer, such as chemotherapy, immunotherapy, the same radiation therapy, and so on. I reported some studies regarding the application of electromagnetic fields in cancer patients. In order to try to use electromagnetic radiation in order to Overhead in order to obtain a major beneficial effects of electromagnetic radiation, some scientists attempts to apply the resonance theory to cancer treatment. A resonance phenomenon occurs when the frequency of an external wave interacting with the system is close to a natural frequency characteristic of the system, inducing an amplification of the vibration of atoms and molecules in order to destroy the system. This could be the aim of the use of electromagnetic radiation at resonance frequencies in order to kill cancer cells. Here I also reported some studies regarding this topic. Nevertheless, also in this case, those models are too simplified, are theoretical models. And indeed, they are based only on the mechanical properties of cells. For instance, we can see the first study regarding the elasticity of a cell. And these properties cannot be considered representative of natural frequencies of cancer cells. Indeed, no experimental application of such theoretical models was carried out up to now. So we would like to use an important physical chemical mechanism in cellular functions in order to apply resonance theory. And this mechanism is the ions flux across cellular membrane channels. Indeed, ions flux in cellular membrane channels have been demonstrated to have a fundamental role in cellular functions of cancer cells, as they can regulate cancer's initiation, progression, and proliferation. This statement is not mine, but it comes from several previous relevant studies in literature. Ions flux alteration in cells membrane channels can be induced by pharmacological therapy, and it occurs when we use chemotherapy, immunotherapy, but also ions flux alteration can be induced by the displacement of proteins alpha helices in cells membrane channels induced by electromagnetic field, such as we have shown in this study. Cellular membrane channels are made by proteins alpha helices that represent the walls of the channel. And the alpha helix is the most representative element of proteins, secondary structure, and it is represented by this right-hand spiral conformation, in which every backbone nitrogen-hydrogen group donates a hydrogen bond to the backbone carbon-oxygen group of the amino acid, and forming this helical conformation. This helical conformation, the alpha helix, in proteins and in cells can be detected by Fourier transform infrared spectroscopy. That is a sophisticated technique in which the vibration bands of organic compounds can be detected and is transformed in a spectrum in which the vibration bands of each compounds, organic compound of the sample can be detected, and using this technique we can obtain useful informations not only on the organic compounds, but also on the eventual external stress which act on the organic compounds. And it is the case of, for instance, the electromagnetic field acting on the organic, on the biological system, such as a cell. Using this technique, we can detect two important vibration bands that are characteristic in proteins that we can see in proteins and in cells. That are the MID1 band that takes into account the vibration bands of carbon-oxygen stretching and nitrogen-hydrogen bending vibrations, and that are oriented, these linkages are oriented along the alpha helix, the axis of the alpha helix. In contrast, the carbon and nitrogen stretching and the nitrogen-hydrogen bending vibrations that give rise to the second vibration band, the second important vibration band, the MID2 band, are perpendicular to the alpha helix axis. So if we see in the spectra an increasing of the MID1 band, it means that the alpha helices are orienting along one direction. In the top of this slide, I schematized the random position of alpha helices in proteins in aqueous solution, and each alpha helix possesses a dipole moment, a relevant dipole moment, depending from the type of protein. And the amount of the total dipole moment increases when these alpha helices are aligned along the direction of the electromagnetic field. That is this situation here on the right of this slide. So if we observe an increasing of the MID1 band, it means that the electromagnetic field induces an alignment of these alpha helices. In addition to this information, we showed that there is a correlation between the alpha helix displacement in cells and the frequency of an applied electromagnetic field. And this is an important result because it leads us to search that frequency at which this displacement is maximum. Indeed, I would like to show before this slide. Indeed, we are on the left. We can see a scheme of a cell membrane channel at rest. On the right, a scheme of a cell membrane channel under an applied electromagnetic field. So, regarding the my previous statement, an alignment of the alpha helices that form the wall of the channel. This alignment induces also an enlargement of cells channel, as we can see here in this on the right of this slide, and this induces also an increase of ions flux. An alteration of ions flux can induce, can damage the cell. in this slide, we can see the alteration of the amide 1 band in neuronal-like cells. They were neuroblastoma cells after exposure to a static magnetic field in the panel A, the electromagnetic field at 50 Hz, the panel B, and electromagnetic field at 900 MHz, the panel C. In red, I represented the vibration band, the amide 1 vibration band after exposure to each type of electromagnetic field. And in this slide, we can see that there is a correlation between the increasing of the vibration band, the amide 1 vibration band, that is an increasing of the alignment of the alignment of the alpha helices, and the frequency of the electromagnetic field which was applied. This effect, would like to amplify this effect in order to use electromagnetic fields in order to irradiate cancer cells by using electromagnetic fields at frequencies close to a natural resonance frequency of cancer cells in order to induce their damage. The model that we can use is a viscoelastic model by which we can describe a cellular membrane channel. And using the classical three parameters representing the spring, damper, and mass elements of a biological system. And the electromagnetic field can be represented by this function. And here, and in the bottom of this slide, we can see the equation of motion of a generic biological system, but this model applies well to a cellular membrane channel. And the solution of this equation is here reported. X0 represents the amplitude of the displacement of this viscoelastic system. And we can see that this value increases when the frequency of the applied field, omega, is close to the omega S, that is the natural frequency of the system. When omega is equal to omega S, we have resonance. The denominator, is close to zero, and the ratio, this ratio increases, inducing an increasing of the amplitude of the system. That is what occurs when we have resonance. The first remark is that I would like to repeat this statement. Ion's flux in cellular membrane channels have been demonstrated to have a fundamental role in cellular functions of cancer cells, as they can regulate cancer initiation, procreation, and proliferation. So, considering Ion's flux, we can help to damage cancer cells. Second remark. The channel in biological membranes are formed by proteins alpha helices. About 60% of proteins in a cell are located in cellular membrane channels. So an eventual increasing of the amide 1 vibration means that that ally, that the dose alpha helices are aligning along the direction of the applied electromagnetic field. If this mechanism occurs during resonance, this amplification, this alignment is maximum, and the ions flux is maximum as well. Third remark, exposure to electromagnetic fields induces the orientation of this alpha helices along the direction of the applied field, causing the enlargement of the channel and inducing an increasing of the flow on the flux of ions across the channel. And I have just said this concept. The fourth remark is that it was already demonstrated that an external stress can change the diameter of channel pores, allowing an alteration of ions flux through the cell. It means that it is not only our discovery. This effect of an enlargement of the diameter of channels in cells was just observed using other external stress. We have demonstrated that this occurs only also using an electromagnetic field. In order to modeling the modeling of ions flux across cells channels are the Ohm's law and Fick's law of diffusion. Coupling these laws, we can obtain an Nernst-Planck equation. The potential difference induces an electric field in the cell channels due to the electromagnetic field that we apply, which drives ions across channels, following Ohm's law that is here reported. I is the channel current, delta V is the membrane potential, and G is the channel conductance. Schematizing a cellular membrane channel by a cylinder with a radius R and a length L, Ohm's law can be written as follows. And applying also Fick's law, we get this other equation, where nabla C is the concentration gradient in the channel, J is the current density, and D is the ions diffusion coefficient. Combining Ohm's law and Fick's law, we get the Nernst-Planck equation applied to cells membrane channel. That is here reported, and it is this simple result is in contrast very interesting, because we can see that the I is the current across the channel due to the ions flux, and it is proportional to the squared of the radius. It means that because of this exponent, it means that only a little change of the radius induces a large increasing of the current, inducing an hyperpolarization in cells environment. A little change of the radius, it is enough, a little change, to induce an alteration of the current. At resonance, we must have a large increasing of the current. Also this effect was experimentally verified because a decreasing of the mitochondrial transmembrane potential was observed after exposure to electromagnetic fields. A decreasing of the mitochondrial transmembrane potential means an increasing of ions flux across the channel. Concluding remarks can be these. I showed that applying electromagnetic fields to cells membrane channels induces their enlargement and the relative increasing of ions flux. At natural resonance frequency of tumor cells, this effect should be amplified, inducing damaging of tumor cells. This concept is very important. Neighboring healthy cells would not be damaged, contrary to what happens using radiation therapy, because the natural resonance frequencies of these healthy cells should be different from those of tumor cells, because every biological system has its natural resonant frequencies that are different from natural resonant frequencies of other biological systems. This last circumstance can be particularly useful for breast cancer in order to possibly avoid breast total surgical removal. And the conclusion of this presentation is that once natural resonance frequencies of cellular membrane channel in breast cancer, how can we search these natural resonant frequencies in breast cancer or in another biological system? For instance, using power generator changing its frequency and searching when we have the observing the samples subjected to a power generator and observing when we have an amplification of MID1 vibration band. When it occurs, we have a resonant phenomenon. Has been found by Fourier transform infrared spectroscopy analysis, but not only using a Fourier transform infrared spectroscopy analysis. We used this technique, but there are also other sophisticated techniques to investigate the infrared spectrum of a biological system. For instance, circular dichroism is another sophisticated technique in which we can measure the angular displacement of alpha helices. Using electromagnetic radiation at that frequency, that can be used for tumor treatment as an adjunct to surgical therapy, in order to reduce its application as much as possible in the attempt to avoid total breast removal. I have finished, and I thank you for your attention.
Yes, thank you so much, Dr. Emmanuel Calabro, for a wonderful presentation. I request other speakers have any questions you can ask now to Emmanuel Calabro.
May I ask a question, please?
Yes.
I'm Paola De Filippi from the University of Torino. I've been really quite interested from this presentation, and I wonder whether this spectroscopic analysis could be applied also to study the differential density of the plasma membrane in different breast cancer tumor cells.
Using this technique, we cannot measure directly the density. The density of biological system, different densities of a biological system. But we can measure, eventually, the difference of the vibration bands that can be due to different densities. So okay. We cannot measure directly different densities, but we can measure only the vibration bands, and we can eventually correlate these the changes of vibration bands with the changes of densities.
Thank you very much. Maybe we can get in contact. Thank you.
Thank you to you too.
Okay, any more questions?